today we are going to play The Park. Now, I don't know what this is, but of course, when I looked it up on the Xbox Store, it was a horror game, so this should be great. The Park is a narrative experience. Well, I'm checking where my headphones, but I'm not in the dark room because it's daytime, but it still works, right? Right? Hopefully. Probably would be better if I was doing this at night, but I'll just record at night. Maybe when I get into my own place, I'll be able to record at night, but now I can't really record at night without waking everybody up. And that's immensely looking very swell. So I should die a couple of times. I'll give you guys that. And hopefully you guys see me freak the hell out. But I should be pretty okay. Don't be like, well, although it probably won't give me a weapon because otherwise it make it too easy. And even if it did, I'd probably end up shooting someone else with it. Yeah, I don't think really arming me is the best solution in this scenario. Unless it's BB gun and we're dealing with animatronic, then yeah, kind of right there. Well, how long are you going to take to load? You should be loaded by that. Okay, I'll scratch that, guys. I'll be back in a minute. Yes, I would like to continue.
I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Atlantic? Very fitting. Again, it's in America. Whoa, what the hell happened to my nose?
Where's Mr. Bear?
I'm a great one to talk.
Haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum.
Jesus Christ.
Stay in the car. Go and ask information.
Yeah. Don't worry, kid. I'm definitely coming back for you. Yeah, you definitely got your... Oh, wait a minute. I can't zoom in. Kid, have you got a gargoyle shirt? Or a dragon shirt? Either way, that is still... extremely cool. Unless it's a neon pet one. To the park it is. Let's go.
Attention, patrons. Okay. The park is now closed. Please make your way to the car park at your earliest convenience. Employees, prepare the park for shutdown.
Right. And I'm walking into it because I'm looking for a bear. Missing bear, everybody. Great. Not like I'm going to get murdered or nothing. Can I open you? Nope. Not open you now. No. Okay. Fair enough. Aha! I see someone. Press A to interact. Let's go there. Okay. Excuse me. Have you seen a bear?
What?
No. This side. I'm kind of blacking out here. Just don't mind me. I swear I ain't been taking anything.
Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine.
those things all the time. Take a deep breath. Think about the last place you saw your son's teddy bear. Hey, stop!
In the park?
I think your boy just ran into the park. I'll unlock the gates for you.
So, if there was locked, how did he get in there? Then? Yeah, this screams out here. Turn that bit up because that sensitivity sucks. Turn that up a bit because I'm deaf as shit.
Callum, I told you to wait in the car.
Over here.
Oh my kid. Welcome. No. Oh, hi. Yeah, thanks for that. Well, it's not exactly
there's something good. Special about the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side,
the apathy of our everyday lives.
And on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Why have I got that axe on it? Can I use that axe? Is it going to be a real life weapon? Oh crap, crap, crap. I've got 70 in it. Yeah, it's definitely gone into mystery, alright. Everything's going to go wrong from here on out. Oh, you guys.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Park. What happened here?
I don't know, but it looks like a bomb hit. Like, fallout. Oh, cool. Camera. What's that?
Come to mommy, Callum.
Little child, come the hell back here. Fine. Let me get my bearings first. Okay. So I'm here. House of Horror. Oh, really, child? Really? Run into House of Horrors? Well, see, something's gonna try to kill me. Nice one. Nice one. Yeah. I hate my little brother. Terrible Tales. Right. Okay. If I get lost, it's just one route until I get to the Octotron. Now that definitely sounds like an enemy. Apart from the... evil robot that's trying to kill you. Sorry about that. My throat was so dry. That don't normally happen to me. Did today. Anyway, child, the House of Horror as it is then. Whee! Okay, not creepy whatsoever. Oh man, I have to go to that. Slap me on the stick and I might as well just go to hell right now. That's exactly where I'm going. Yeah, you're not going to come and live nick me, are you? Here goes nothing. Gonna get eaten
too
by...
dark. Oh. I'm not going in there without a flashlight.
Of course not. Smart decision, really. You know, one must enter hell with a flashlight. Ah. assuming. It's back at the start, isn't it? Not a trash bag everywhere. Sorry, I'm taking too long now. Is that a... Oh, no, that's trash. I thought that was a saw blade, to be honest. It doesn't look like a saw blade. I know it's dead. Is there a flashlight in here? No, because it looks too dark. Does anybody know?
It's easy to get lost here.
Where a flashlight could be. Anyone at all? No. It's not great. Okay, don't worry, creepy house of horrors. I will be back for you when I find the flashlight. Nothing's creepy, nothing unusual about this. I'm just trying to find a flashlight while looking for my son. Everything is oddly going darker. I hope that was just birds. That's a nice shoot. Oh.
I think this belongs to Kelm.
Oh, shit. He's probably fine. Oh, what the hell are you?
Chad the Chipmunk, huh? Just a drunk guy in a suit.
Chad the Chipmunk, welcome you to Atlantic Island Park. Chad has been seen in day Ashcross, chosen the following locations. Chad Chipmunk, worst in class. Chad can't even see to pass. Chad gets angry, likes to fight. Chad is beaten every night. Chad will have a dead end job. Chad will die in a useless slop. I will die a useless slop. Living AM Sideshow Alley. One show free package. So, and I've got it timed. Oh. Oh. So I'm trying to struggle to read it, but I'm not struggling because I've got my glasses on. Blown with a shadow. Come on. Don't like the look of you. Well, at least you've got a colourful pouch. Wait a minute. Is that eye following me? You say that. Something tell me, I'm gonna see Chad real soon. Still okay down there, are you, buddy? Yeah, great. As long as you don't move yet. As long as you don't move yet, we're fine. Chad, you still down there? Yeah, he's still down there. Tunnel or tell? Right, okay. My flashlight there.
Callum, stay where you are!
Come on, Mommy!
Child, why do you want me to go into this ride? Let's go. Hello?
I'm not playing anymore, Callum.
No, but still he wants me to ride this one. So let's ride this one, shall we? That's because I didn't have that. Came off the tram because they're not supposed to come off the tram. Oh, harness. This looks like a harness little ride. Yeah, apart from a bit splashed to death because I don't really do one of these rides. Ouch, my back. Oh, ow.
Near a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter, his wife and his two children. A boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel.
Hansel and Gretel.
They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup.
Uh-oh. Tell me the tale of Hansel and Gretel now.
What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband. We will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them
what,
there.
Me?
No, my wife. I cannot do that, said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began to weep. Do not
I'm
fret,
sure
Gretel,
it was nothing. I'm sure I just
said.
Hit her.
He crept out of the hut and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets.
Get her up. Yeah.
The next morning, the woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day.
Oh, hello, Chad.
A clever hat leaves a tray of white stones behind them as they pass into the woods.
I see you again.
When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house. After receiving a thorough scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without
this
any
This is really embarrassing
supper.
For you.
Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked.
I'm not really here for you.
Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter.
How do you know I had a conversation with Chad? I was just doing this,
and led them deep into the forest.
Somehow, games give me achievements to have a conversation with Chad.
Hansel broke his bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds
I'm
snatched
glad
up the breadcrumbs and his trail
breadcrumbs.
Was destroyed.
I have a feeling that Chad might be behind me.
Abandoned by their parents. Unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days.
I'm just listening to Hansel and Gretel here, guys. I don't want Chad being behind.
The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly strange house. Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls.
Time to eat the house. Eat the house, girl. Oh, there she is, the old hag.
Little mouse.
The old hag across the land.
At my house. An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes. Oh, you dear
you must be
children.
So hungry.
You
just give up so I can eat you.
How come to you? But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their mother.
That's very nice.
Come, children, don't be afraid.
You're still right there, buddy. Still haven't moved. Great.
The old woman offered them two enormous lollipops. The children took them and began to eat.
Normally I would say
you
don't
see,
accept
nothing to fear
candy
here.
Strangers, but
come inside.
We do that a lot on Halloween,
urged,
so
and the children,
I do as well.
Still licking their sweets, followed.
What was that
once
noise?
The house, the old woman
again?
She stuffed Hansel into a cage and put Gretel to work, sweeping, cleaning her hut. Your brother will make a good mouthful, the old witch told Gretel.
Yeah, don't mind me,
once
I'm just trying to
buttoned up, I shall feast upon him.
No, that's just Peter Rock. Oh no.
Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven.
Is clearly big enough,
but Gretel pretended not to understand. I do not know how. Where is the opening? Fool! The old witch said, "The opening is here."
Chat for a minute.
And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old witch tumbled forward into the oven.
Kid power, people,
Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel, and together they lit a fire beneath the oven. And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled, and the witch was cooked. And then, because even children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.
I don't remember that in the nation, whatever. Kind of tipped into cannibalism quite early there, Hansel Gretel. Yeah, the sweet house. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be telling my children that one. No. Is it right there, Chad? You're still in there, creepy people out. My god, it's even got the range issue sound as it fall out. Okay, that was lovely, but if you excuse me, I'm just gonna go. You know, swans, gingerbread, and chocolate. What a sweet, delicious. What a sweet.
Hansel and Gretel.
Human.
I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest, the birds, the old witch. Even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister. Hand in hand against the unkind world.
We
were always hungry. Looking for our own house made of candy. Looking for the sweetness that could take the pain away.
Candy
hunger leads people to desperate,
away,
terrible places. Where the tree branches reach the claws.
But I still got all my teeth. And I've got extremely sweet tooth. Extremely sweet tooth. I don't know why. I don't know. And I think my son kind of as well. For that, or he's just a chocolate. I think he's just chocolate like me as well. Okay, that was nothing.
Another accident. This
place. There's nothing wrong with it. Okay. Where can I? Shit. Deeply constant interruptions by the fancy electric iron park opening on time governed to book cut the river. Right, okay. I'm not throwing away the customers will simply curious to start closing my knees. Up to your head, Vince. That's right. Okay. So that's the guy I'm gonna blame if everything goes wrong.
Alright. Mommy is coming, Callum!
Yeah, you say that! Mommy's coming, Callum!
Callum,
stay
where you are!
Mommy's coming. Wait a minute, I think I found the bear, Callum! I think I found the teddy bear! Oh, wait, what? Is that blood?
Mommy's
getting pretty freaked out at the moment, so if you would just give her a flashlight at least. Yeah. Damn child in front of me. Oh. We have a full moon tonight. Handy. Well, not really that handy because Okay, I have not found a flashlight and the fish right is open. The thing. My forgiveness.
This old thing used to make the blood run to my head. Make me dizzy. Callum? Where'd you go?
Creepy one.
The guy just snapped. Those poor kids.
What? Make this creep normal statement. We are waiting for our turn on the ride, Frank and me and the boy. This fellow in the chipmunk suit might be less talking to people to or take Frank off. Lawrence wants to go over there, but he was a bit worried as the sorts of people creeps or something. Anyway, the chipmunk men use carving the people may at life. And at first, he thought he was making some animal like tiger or lion, but more than ice. And finally, first look, it was a human face. Hey, there's a creep right there. Smiling at on the block fire. Yeah, that would have been a dead body, you do. When you first look, it looked like a human face, smiling at the block glass. But the more you looked at it, the more you saw that there was something not quite right about the proportions. Yeah, that was a dead body, you don't realise that. How was boy? You have to be this big.
Get on while
it's moving. Oopie. Increase speed? No, I won't increase the speed. Oh, to ride the whirly thing. Against everything I can't say that I didn't say that to ride. So, let's ride it, shall we? Let's ride to out there, shall we? Come look. Oh, of course not. You have to wait for it to stop. The proper fashion. The car could be creepier. You know you can stop at any time soon, right? Right. Maybe if I give it another job, it is gonna let you stop. Yeah, great. Thank you. I'm going to write this thing. Bye, son. Probably. Bye. Oh, look, at least I've got a safety box, I suppose. Now, show me the chipmunk of my scariest desire. Eyes are Is that the creepy old man? Oh, wait a minute. What's that? You stopped it. Right? Thank you. Thank you for stopping everything. Hi, mister. Yeah, thanks for the examining part. No, I'm not about that.
Why do you look pissed off? This.
I see. What? I was like, why do I look pissed off? Me and Callum. Well, me. Why do you look pissed off and Callum looks kind of scared to be with you? I don't like the way this is suit options.
Treachery hides in thoughts. Treachery that lashes like a whip and scars our insides. The first time I saw Callum, my thoughts betrayed me.
That's your fault.
I looked down at this wrinkled red bawling thing and I thought, is that it? We built our world from expectations, and the world that I had built for Callum was no different. He was so real. So
still
there,
shocked that I haven't got
so
a
far
flash
from my expectations.
I shattered,
and as they fell in pieces, that one treacherous thought became a new foundation. All of the love that we shared, all of the warmth and goodness that followed, built on a single traitorous thought.
Read this, shall we? Blow it off, thank you. I thought working in the park for summer would be a lot of fun. By the end of the season, it was real great. There ain't many toys around. So, Steve, Gus Brown, Gus Green, most of them is Belcher, Steve, see? Okay, this is really starting to freak me out. See, even I'm starting to call him Chad, and I went to school with the guy. This is that goddamn suit. And I'm getting it was a laughter. See, was the local lush, as Chad, Chetlock, Brendan, and Mascot, and I'm apart, lock up your daughters and all that blah 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 blah. Yeah, Steve sounds like right charmer. But the more he wears that suit, the weirder Steve gets. And the first thing he like refuses to change out the suit at work and take it home with him every day. But I saw him, so he did, I'm still wearing it. Yeah, wearing all the work day. And Steve complained. The top manager about the smell and saw him walking around talking with Mr. Winters dying on one day, but nothing seems to change. So it still smelled like carpet whenever Steve walked by, and apparently Steve has picked up new skills since I saw him plucked up the guitar outside the station because he sure as hell carved a mean nice sculpture. As though shaved inmates in the last day give me a creep. See if Ken finds a move to me. Lucky me. He hanged around for a while. I couldn't really tell because the suit, it seemed like he was just staring at me, sizing me up. Fucking me. I fucking me. Whatever he was doing. Yeah, I hate when guys do that. I asked him what he wanted and he just stood there not saying anything, thinking I've got my supervisor. When he's come back, Chad, Steve wandered off, my supervisor told me to put everything right, so he is. Also, I quit. I don't want to see that chipmunk suit ever again. Laura Henneman. I don't blame you, Laura. I would like get out of Was that your supervisor by chance? He was a lovely guy, you know. He had a lovely hat. Oh, what a horrible mess on you. Oh, no. Okay, it's not gonna kill me if I touch it, right? Okay. What about if I turn my back on it? Will it come in? No. Okay. test over and find everybody. I haven't died yet. Where am I now? Bumper cars.
Constant okay. Crashes and 80s music.
So,
guess it floats someone's boat.
Yes. No, that's not the right way. Sounds fun, let's go. Some nice little flies. I'm a device expert. That's definitely a shocking revolution right there. Just wanna ride the bumper cars, man. Ride the bumper cars. That's all I wanna do. Sure that's nothing. Right, this one's on. Can I drive this one? Yes! Oh no. Thanks, I have an accident report. Fine. Accident report. Focus bit. Tell his name. Frank Francis is different. Time of date of accident, 25th. Bloody hell. 1976. Nice. Labour is working on the crane. Supervisor leaves. Richard Stanston. Witness is lawyer. Creed, there was a witness and a lawyer at the same time. Oh no, the witness is called Lawrence. My bad, I thought that was a lawyer. Brief description of the accident or incident. During the transport was a bumper car, modern aviars, modern straps, attacked, loading track, I'm tired, right, okay. Was in chaos and front cards Francis. Who's directly stand directly to the driver? Right. Oh. Oh. Poor Francis. Francis was killed. Let's take a moment for Francis, shall we? Guys. Is the MG a poi see a toss? Francis died, and it still said, did the engineer probably see doctor? Yeah, no, we didn't die with him last time. That's not the strangest thing that happened. The strangest thing is, we went to see a doctor, guys. If yes, supervisor comments, Dexter. Truck driver claims to have seen someone on the back of the load doing undoing the straps. Was it Chip or a Chad? Provide them with urine samples. Okay, thinking everyone's on drugs, fair enough. What was that noise? After the unsafe position's been corrected, no. Okay. Right, come out of that. I thought there was a weird sound. Oh wait. Shit. Francis, is that you? Kind of getting off a bit early, aren't you, mate? No. Yeah, I know, Blake. new crash and everything, but a bit early for that. But thank you for showing me your way, Francis. Thank you very much. Greatly appreciated. Glad I took that 2 minutes to find us now.
It's a matter of public record that I had a failure as a mother. Once, when Callum was very small, I left him asleep in the car while I ran an errand. Don't even remember what it was.
Yeah.
When I came back, the sheriff was standing next to the car, watching my boy through the window.
Well, no wonder why.
I didn't like what I saw in his eyes. Judgment.
He
wrote me the ticket without saying a word. Just the scratch of his pen on the notepad. When he gave it to me, our eyes met. I know what you're going through. My daughter, Helen, she just gets some help. Help was a bolt of lightning. Help was 1,000 volts surging through my veins. Help is agony. I'd rather die. I wanted to scream. I'd rather you pulled your gun and shot me. But instead, my mouth said, yes, Sheriff.
Why is that wrong? Why is that rock making noise at me? Oh, damn, that's a big fairy swamp. Still not doing my flashlights here, guys. Still not doing my flashlights here. Just to make your way. How's boy, I know my pace to read. Continue delayed with good confidence of builders. Delayed confidence of builders, all that. The problem is that the locals in the little rumors about old man Hendrix. Used to be. Oh yes, then tales of old man Hendrix. They grew up on those tales. Every time a bolt came loose or a wrench got missing, they scores crossing themselves against the black magic. Of course, that's why I chose this site. Okay, Solomon Island. Yeah, make my skin crawl. I call back your favours and group the. No, yeah, great. Wait a minute, was that? Oh, right. Yeah. Okay. Still no flashlight here. Wait, what was that? Where's that? Cape of the bumper cars, so I should have moved past the rock carousel. I feel like I shouldn't have gone to the ferris wheel in the bumper car. There. Oh, there, that way. Back to Ultratron. Okay, I feel like this ferris wheel is coming to me. Let's go by the ferris wheel, shall we, ladies and gentlemen? See what wonders this beholds to me. First, I'm going to read this report. Okay.
So they are going to close this place down. Doesn't surprise me.
And I'm so close to the park. Oh boy, let's go by the ferris wheel. It's bloody unsafe ride. Why not? Why not, people? Why not? So would like to ride this roller coaster. This roller coaster is very swell. That's unsafe for me to ride on the tour. Nothing bad is going to happen whatsoever. Let's go. Yeah, you know. Oh, yeah, another seat. Yeah, you know that would be the place for my son. No, I got a salmon plate. So I said, just 10 so I said, yeah, no, no one's gonna come and come and bring me out. So,
people come into your life for a reason. Dad used to say that before Mom ran off.
Tragedy.
After that, he just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or cop a feel like the others.
As you do.
He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed. It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale.
Oh yes.
I can't tell you if Callum was made that night or one of the ones that followed. But I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night.
No,
Don and I moved in together, but then
you get married.
Well,
you have a child.
According to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment.
Yeah, I didn't get married.
Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Callum.
Everyone wants that fairy tale.
Fairy tale fucking over.
Oh look, I've got the most skinniest fingers ever. Well, this ride was lovely. It was unsafe whatsoever. Yeah, really. Hello again. Excuse me, sir. Are you friendly? Are you not friendly? What was that? What was that? Pick up or read or whatever. No, nothing, nothing. Oh, okay, great. Well enough. Fanny glass in or about is actually going to try and find my son, shall we? Can't believe I won't miss out on it and I still haven't found my son. Or a flashlight. That is completely strange, I haven't found a flashlight at all. Oh, lovely. So, oh, that's why it's unsafe. One of them was missing. Wait. Nobody could kill her whatsoever. Yeah, I'm sure it's nothing. What do you think, creepy child baby? Oddly enough, looks up to me, but without the hair. Yeah, I'm just gonna go after this very spill thing. Well, Kavini, I'll block my path.
A lot of people idolize their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit. My angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people! You give up 9 months of your life carrying them, you traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Wiping asses, mopping up piss, feeding them, little life-sucking monsters who take and take and take until... We all go insane. Any parent who pretends otherwise is just dishonest. That's called choice supportive bias. I am honest. Callum really grinds my gears, and he owes me everything. Everything. It served the little fuck right if I just abandoned him.
Go fuck yourself. Being a parent is a wonderful experience. You love and cherish him. Second of all, you shouldn't be a bad mother. Now, can you look after your children for a change? It's instead of getting lost in any goddamn park. And thirdly, why am I even discussing this with a video game? I should be discussing this with the blame developers of this game. We probably have children. So, why am I even making this argument? So fucking... You know... I hate when people fucking talk about. I really do. I mean, just because you feel like that against your kids, don't mean everyone else fucking does. You wonder why your children's fucking messed up, isn't it? Yeah. And you wonder why the social is so hard on people because of them fucking people. Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. That's my little rent over. I don't know what happened. Can't overcome me. My pride of being a new mother. Let's just go on the roller coaster and kill this bitch, shall we? Now, I'll be glad if you died. I'm not gonna mourn you whatsoever. So let's just ride this roller coaster before you piss me off even more. Okay? Ups and down. Well, your life is gonna be up and down.
What do you want?
We need to talk about Callum.
What do you mean? What have you done to him?
That's insulting. You and your boy are everything that this place doesn't want. The antithesis of what we stand for.
Where is Callum?
The poor child. He tried so hard to do what he was taught. He even left you a trail of breadcrumbs. But the park is just so hungry.
Tell me where my son is.
What's that?
Which has him now? Has both of you. No happy ending here, I'm afraid.
Just leave me alone.
Also, I feel like this is something that Ellen's family. Yes, that's exactly what I did. My duct tape and flashlight. Oh, how do
the
I...
witch awaits.
Turns on the flashlight. How do I fucking get out of this question? Okay. Let me out, please.
Callum has bruises on his arms, finger marks. Right. Someone has been hurting him. I've asked him, demanded really, to know where he got the marks. But he doesn't want to answer me.
So
something has scared him into silence. Okay. He doesn't dare talk.
This path.
He's been changing too.
Okay.
Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns and cries out words that I cannot understand. When I try to soothe him, he snaps and bites at my fingers.
I think he wants to tell you that.
I think he wants to talk to me.
Traumatized woman.
I think he wants to tell me. But they are watching him every minute of every day. They are whispering to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me. I can't save him. There will be pain.
Yeah.
But I love him, and in the end, he will understand why.
Oh, look. Let's laugh at the clown, shall we? You do straight up. Yeah, why not? Why not?
The whole town was shocked by that one.
Tasted.
Never found out who did it.
Can't go his mouth. Ew. Yeah, thanks. I learned about Chad. Ew. It's so ew. You guys echo. Chad? I feel like I have to sneak around. Or at least be careful. The management is not responsible for disease contracted by the kitty boots. Oh, lovely. It's all you might have got. Ah, yeah. Maybe it was Chipmunk or Chad.
Did this to him?
Yeah. Can I go investigate the cloud head? Right. Jack. Okay. I'm back. Let me get in. Great. Oh, is it? Great. Can't get out this way. What are you going to need to be in? Take pills. Don't tell me everything. Oh, my fucking head. Please don't tell me that.
These are mine.
Yeah. Let's go take your 1980s. Oh, you bit off as if we're for you. Say no to your brother. Not safe to leak. Oh. Fuck, take long. Astroid reality. Fear the bogey man. Stop picking your stick. No, right. Bogey man. Oh, I get it. Bogey man. Stop picking your nose, child. Oh, I can move. Only dead fish follow the stream. clearly she has the higher stats. Well, yeah, most people do. Say no to graffiti. Well, clearly I have said no to it because it's all over the walls. Some kids laugh and some kids cry, but mostly children sit and die. Charming message. Charming. All that you will be loved will be carried away. Yeah, 1980s suck. Don't believe anything they tell you. Okay, fair enough. Hi. Hi. Wow. Wow. Let's do that again. Wow. Destroy the bed. Why not? Okay.
Don't touch me.
Read these papers.
Forgive me,
Callum. I've already read this newspaper. Oh, no. Use the types. Oh, it's a different one. Belly button, sex and sex. I believe her name was Mama. Mama? Was there a horror movie based on Mama? I swear of it. She may seem. Yeah. Yeah. Mama. Yeah. You can see that happening. So, I'm getting chased by Mama. Great. Okay. Fair enough. What are you guys looking at? Yeah, what are you laughing at? Punch your nuts. Oh, look. Wow. Didn't move. Great. Pickle punks. Oh. Grow your own pickle punk. Yeah, why not? Oh, hello. I have seen them. They're more. I have seen them. Look at all these cuts on my body. I have seen them. But I can't remember them. Do not forget. And a suggestion was like to pass out. Yeah, that was definitely a strange trip. I'll give it that. Okay. Thank you for telling me that. Oh, where am I? Oh, the gate's open. Never.
The park is a collage of contradictions all of its own. Millions of people die every year in car crashes. And the park has little cars designed specifically to simulate that action. Hear the children scream with joy. In a sideshow alley, you can walk away with 15 cents worth of mass-produced Chinese teddy bears, while a grinning carny pockets your hard-earned $5. And what secrets lie beneath the sullen waters of the lake? The tears of jilted lovers, the soiled condoms of illicit affairs, the clotted blood of the lonely suicide. And the face of the witch looms over it all. I always despised a toothy grin and warty nose.
Get a bit
I hate that sparkle in her weathered, watchful eyes.
So,
I think Callum is waiting for
go,
me.
You know.
Inside.
What is that? My flashlight. Seems like I've got my flashlight here. Yeah. Got everything we need, yes. Come to me, my baby boy.
This isn't a game, Callum!
The power.
Come back!
Bitter, great. This is what I get going outside. On a hot day, I get bitter. Do death. Great. Oh, great. I hate this. How much little light I have. Hey, Chad, buddy. How's it going? Oh, wait a minute, I'll test your little funky little little picture. Done. Closed escape. Oh, great. Okay. Okay. Fair enough. Fair enough.
Sandwich?
Yes, please.
One or two?
Two, please.
Would you like ham or cheese?
Can I have both, please?
Ham and cheese,
yeah. Thank you. Oh, I hate these pictures already. Let's go to our desk, shall we? At last. That is cool. Guy from Monster from Doom. And a broke box. Oh, yeah. Don't I look pathetic? Drugged up already. Bye then. By. At least I've got a reflection, I suppose. Books, loads of books. Hi. Hi, you've been released, have you? What a lovely smile you've got there, by the way. You can take a bit of screenshot of you, yeah, try not to kill me, run away. Lovely place you got here. Yeah, great. Can I get through these doors? No, I don't think so. Let's try one more time. Yeah, no. Hello. Chad, buddy, yeah, you know you're not going to kill me, right? You wouldn't do that, yeah. Oh, hi. You're that little bit, right? Your racket clank lane. Yeah. Don't this buddy Chad of mine. Great fellow here, it's a great fellow. Yeah, I feel like he's trying to kill me, but he wouldn't do that, no. Yeah, he wouldn't do that. He's a sweetheart, really. Man, what the hell, bud? Completely and utterly lost. I'm feeling like you took me up here for some reason. Oh, hey there. Hey there, old man. Where are you? Excuse me. I asked the question, so that's not old man.
Where is he?
Never told me. Where's my child? Anyone there?
Don't leave me!
Not back. Ah, yeah. Good old flashlight. Go away. Ah. Room of mirrors. Everything. Oh, no. Ah, let's go towards that on this red light, shall we? Yeah, nothing bad's gonna happen here. That's an odd one to have. Hi. Wait, why don't I turn around now? Why did I just check this pen? Thank you for opening the door for me. Little dog went out one day. Where is my boy? Not the badge you give it to me.
Where is my boy?
Come on. Don't start freaking out now. There's different ways this is not gonna kill me. Is somebody home? Oh, look at that lovely drawing. Nightmare circus. Oh, well, no wonder you're having bad dreams. A circus burned to the ground was every night killing dozens of owners, but puts death in the race. Nice. Sounds interesting.
After they let me out, they gave me Callum back and sent me home with a handful of breadcrumbs. Home bit a sweet home. I barely recognized it. Where there had been color and light, were shadows and regrets. Where there had been warmth, there was a bone-deep coldness that never went away. I tried my hardest to keep the ghosts at bay. Don, watching from the dusty corners while I tried to teach his son to read. My father, coldly assessing me and finding lack in. I devoted myself to Callum, did the things that they told me. It will get better, they said. Every day will be a little better than the last. I'm in the woods now. Lost and afraid. Things never got any better.
I love you, Barbie. But why does the child have packed secrets? That's concerned. Enjoy with this. Milk, cheese, bread, butter, corn, potatoes, apples, fish sticks. Remember, drop a cannon, electric bills, fix 40. Serve it. Okay. Done and done. Nope, locked it. Cannot open. Make something over. Can I have the wrench? Okay, please give me the wrench. I'd like. No, okay, maybe not. Yes, it's a nice, fine looking wrench. What's in the fridge? Oh, yes, lovely. Mate. Everything that we've had on our shopping list. Clearly. This will be really. Lord Callum, I received your letter and I'm quite surprised you ran off with your father all those years ago. Disappeared off the edge of the map, finally tracked you down, and you refused to answer and you wanted it. And now you write to me asking for help. I have another family now. even though I feel Park was horrible bad, I don't regret the years I wasted with him. I love you, I truly did, but every year you grew more cool like him, but his girl was never really mine. Great. Still, I fought for custody at how if you haven't run away with him, if you haven't broken my heart, go on living. I cannot let go of your life without picking open a wound. I'm not ready to forgive you. Please don't contact me again, Karen. Fair enough, Karen. Fair enough. Totally understandable. Oh, look. What is it? It says it was a toy. It's the most strange looking toy I've ever seen. Okay, another notice. Emergency services. Okay. Millard Little Kimbler. Okay. Discharged, so she was discharged the same year. Diagnosis depression. Great. Note from those instances, Laura has been suffering from depression early in her pregnancy. So she has the baby blues, does she? That explains a lot why she's a fucking bitch against her children. So thank you. Oh, great. If you're based, so yeah. Yeah, that would be it. Why is this one black? It's a dollar a billion. So probably beneficial with your estate if it includes life insurance. Blah, 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 blah. So yeah, okay. Nobody's black here, so turning here. Hello. Okay. I'm sorry, but I have to leave it there for a minute. I will see you later and goodbye. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more of the park. Goodbye.